Okay, so that's how the zombified analog TV looks like. As you can see, that's perfectly normal TV, nothing fancy hanging around or anything to give up the impression that that's a perfectly normal TV. See what happens once I switch it on and start it. Well, the first thing that happens under the hood is that I have positioned my Android phone and it starts shooting the person in front of the TV to document the reaction of the prank. So let's wait a minute and whoops, the TV just switched on and it even syncs the message, and then it starts playing Time, the song Time from Pink Floyd. Now, how's that happening? The secret, if we remove that thing, it's here. That's Raspberry Pi, and there is a Wi-Fi connector to it. The Wi-Fi connector is used to turn on the... Okay, I'll switch the TV off. It notifies the Android phone to start recording. And meanwhile, if we lift the TV a little, you can see below, here are my cables which I use to detect whether the TV is on and or off, and to control the TV to switch from coaxial input to audio video. But the question is, how does it happen? Okay, focus. How does it happen when there's nothing here? Well, luckily for me, it contains a SCART. Okay, that connector, and it's in the back, it's not visible, and this connector goes down, and yeah, here's the Pi, and from there it goes to the TV. And yeah, that's how it looks like in short. For the digital TV, it's pretty much the same. But there, instead of controlling directly the TV, it's just switching the HDMI inputs. But the real cool stuff with this one is that that's an analog TV, and people cannot, how to say, relate that to a modern thing like web browsers and making this TV zombified and showing some messages that you usually see on your computer is really surprising, so to speak. So, yeah, that's it, guys. Bye.